Good day. If this is your first time to the channel, welcome. I'm TMac. I help pilots just like you start and continue their journey to better FPV fun through videos like this one and the Fast Track FPV course, which will get you in the air having fun flying FPV in minimal time, at less overall cost, and in a safe and responsible manner. It's through the Fast Track FPV course I'm able to provide more detailed instruction and on a more individualized and personal basis. You're welcome to check out the course curriculum and student reviews through the Fast Track FPV course link in the video description below. Let me ask you something. Honestly, how often do you fly at full throttle? That much, huh? Okay, I'll come back to that question in just a bit. Over the past week, I received a couple questions from folks wondering how they could tame down their quad to make it easier to control. In this video, FPV Beginner Tips, I go over three ways to do just that.
Today we're going to go over three FPV beginner tips, which you can implement before you start flying, that'll help you learn to fly FPV the right way, more quickly, and with more confidence. The first tip we'll be going over is the FPV camera angle. The more the camera angle, the faster forward speed you will have to maintain that altitude. The second of our FPV beginner tips is to use Acro Trainer mode.
And in this video, Better FPV Throttle Control, I show you how you can use a throttle curve with Betaflight or your transmitter to get better throttle resolution around a specific throttle percentage or altitude, which can result in smoother videos. Today, I'm going to show you another simple yet effective tip you can use with the Jumper T16 and OpenTX to better control your throttle, which can also give you longer flight times and smoother video. It's useful for both rookie FPV pilots just learning how to fly and is also used by experienced FPV racers as well. It's called throttle limit or scaling, and I'm going to show you how to do it with your Jumper T16. Ready to get your throttle control dialed in? Then give this video a thumbs up below, share it with your pilot buddies, and subscribe to your TMac FPV channel, your home for your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing stuff.
Okay, back to that full throttle question. First, I'm briefly going to explain what we're about to do and why it's going to be helpful for you. Then I'm going to show you how to make it happen, and here in a few minutes, I've even got a little bonus for you to go along with it. So stay with me here. Most folks think of their current throttle percentage going from 0% at stick minimum to 100% throttle at stick maximum. Let's just say for the sake of argument that some of us don't use the top 25% of our throttle or 75% throttle on up. This means the top quarter of your throttle stick movement from here to here is seldom, if ever, used. You can find out how much you actually use that portion of your throttle by enabling the throttle position element in your OSD and replaying your DVR footage to see how many times, if at all, you used it. You may find or already know that the majority of your flying is done within 25 to 75%, depicted here in green. Or maybe even within 25 to 50%, as shown here in purple. Let's put these two over here on the side on the floor for a minute. If you rarely or never use the top 25% portion of your throttle, you're wasting that amount of stick movement, or what I'll call stick throw, when you could actually be using it for something else to improve your flying skills. Let's take a look at how we can do that. I'm going to give you something that's going to allow you to change what your throttle percentage is when your stick is at its maximum position. So instead of your throttle being at 100%, when your stick is at its max throw, you can make that max stick position be, say, 75% throttle, or 50% throttle, or whatever percent throttle you want it to be. So how's that going to help you out, and what does it do for you? First of all, it means you're going to be using the entire range of movement of your throttle stick, its entire throw. This means you're going to have better resolution, throttle resolution, for the range of percent throttle that you actually use. By better throttle resolution, what I mean is you're able to move your throttle stick rather significantly, which results in smaller movements from your quad than previously. It, in effect, becomes less sensitive and easier to control. What you're actually doing is changing the scale of your throttle to more effectively use that portion of your throttle range in which you normally fly. Or another way of looking at it is this. You can now move your throttle the same amount as before, and your quad will increase its motor speed less. This, of course, in turn means your quad's going to be less responsive to your throttle stick inputs. However, you're going to gain much more precise control of your quadcopter speed in any given direction. This greatly improves your ability to control the altitude of your quadcopter in flight. The bottom line is this. It can be a very good thing. So let's see how to make it happen. Let's get our throttle control dialed in. To do that, we're going to go to our Jumper T16 OpenTX mixer page.
Okay, we go to our mixer page. And if you'd like a refresher on what mixers are and how they interact with the rest of the flow of information within OpenTX, check out this video, Jumper T16 OpenTX Basics, which I'll link to in the video description below. Let's take a look at what our throttle channel values are within OpenTX before we start changing our throttle scale. Remember I mentioned earlier OpenTX uses minus 100 to 100 as its scale for most things. So we look down here at our throttle channel values with the throttle in its minimum position, and we see it's right around minus 100. With the throttle at its maximum position, we get a value of plus 100. We're about to change these values by programming our switch 2 or S2 as a source for two new mixer lines for our throttle. So these minus 100 and 100 values don't really intuitively mean anything. However, they are important for doing the math in order to get the right numbers we need to input into our mixer lines. The math behind each of the mixer lines is described by the equation shown on the screen, where mixer line value equals source value times the weight, with the offset value added to that product. The result of our two new mixer lines will be that we can change the maximum value of our throttle when at full stick deflection simply by turning S2 to our desired position. We're literally going to have our throttle dialed in. The way that I'm going to program S2 is such that when it's at its max position all the way to the right, the throttle is not limited at all, and it acts as it normally would when at its fully deflected max position. When S2 is at its minimum value, all the way to the left, the maximum throttle value will be 50% of what it would have been without throttle limit, and when S2 is in the middle at its detent, the throttle value will be 75%, just as we described using the range scales earlier. Of course, you can set S2 to any position you want between 50% and 100% max throttle with these two mixer lines we're about to employ. I'm just using those three values for demonstration purposes. So let's go ahead and make those mixer lines. We go down to our throttle channel and insert after and plug our numbers in with the multiplexing down here as multiply. Our source is going to be S2, so we click on that, and then we just turn S2, and it autofills. Click to exit. Our weight, we're going to change to 25. Once again, these numbers are derived from the equation I mentioned earlier. And the offset, we're going to have at 75. And click on that. And that's the important stuff. Our source, weight, offset, and multiplex. Now we can go back up here to mix name and name it whatever we want, or we can leave it blank. For the sake of saving time, I'm just going to leave it blank. So let's exit out of here. And now we see that we've got this one mixer line with the multiplication sign underneath channel 3 for our throttle. Let's go ahead and add our second line, which is needed just because the math works out that way. So we're going to insert after. This time we're going to keep our multiplex at add, because of the math. Our source is going to be S2, just as it was earlier. Our weight we're going to change to 25. And our offset is going to be minus 25. And once again, these numbers are derived from the equation mentioned previously. Okay, now let's see what our throttle values are when our stick is in its fully deflected max position. So with S2 in its max position to the right, all the way to the right, our throttle values have not changed. Max is at 100, minimum is at 100. With S2 in its minimum position, all the way to the left, our throttle value has changed as indicated, which corresponds to our initial scale of 50% throttle. With S2 in its middle position, at its detent, our max throttle value has changed as indicated here, corresponding to our intuitive scale of 75% throttle. And as mentioned, you can change your max throttle value to anything in between what's normally 50% and 100% throttle with these mixer lines. Okay, now, I promised you earlier a little bonus. Just as a reminder, I've programmed an audio alert to remind me anytime I've got throttle limit engaged. That way, I won't inadvertently be flying with a max throttle of 50%, when actually what I want to be flying with is 75%. I've made a custom soundtrack for that purpose, and if you'd like to know how to make your own custom soundtrack, check this video out on Jumper T16 Custom Sounds. In addition to the custom soundtrack, we need to add a logical switch, as depicted here on line 5. I used line 5 for my logical switch, where I've stated A is less than X, where the variable A is actually our switch S2, and X is the value 100 when S2 is in its full max position to the right. So this logical switch L5 will be activated, let me move up here so that you can see it, anytime S2 is less than at its max position of 100, which means the throttle acts as it normally would. So anytime S2's value is less than 100, which means our throttle limit has been activated to some value, this logical switch is going to be activated. Watch this L5 as I turn X2. See how it got bold? That means it's activated. Let me turn it back to its max position, and it's inactive. Next, we need to make a special function using this logical switch, and to do so, we go to our special functions page, and I've used special function 6 line to be initiated when L5 is active. So special function 6 is initiated when L5 is active, and it plays a track, and the track it plays is the custom sound I made. So when the logical switch is activated, this special function will play my custom soundtrack like this when I turn S2 to limit my throttle.
TMac, throttle limit engaged.
So that's another way you can get your throttle control dialed in using your Jumper T16 and OpenTX. If you like this video, make sure to hit the like button below, subscribe, and hit the bell to be notified every time I publish a new video. If you want more good info to speed you on your journey to better FPV fun, make sure to check these out next. Thanks for your time. I'll see you next video. Clear skies, friends.